Assalamu alaikum. Welcome back after the short break in conversation with Shaykh Kazi Lutfur Rahman, who is the respected Imam and Khateeb of the famously known mosque, Regent's Park Mosque. Our tonight's topic for discussion is do not abuse. And we've been discussing in the first segment about how, as Muslims, should we look after our roles and responsibility and ensure that not only our action but also our words should not hurt any other individual. Inshallah, we'll be continuing our discussion. And thank you to all of those who have joined us again, once again, through our Facebook page, and inshallah in future you'll also find this program on our YouTube channel, and on the following day, which is tomorrow, you will see the repeat of the very same program. Now, if you do have any questions, suggestion, please feel free to email us, and the email will be displayed at the bottom of your TV screen. But for your kind reference, it's towardstheorigin@chsuk.tv. Now, Sheikh, before we went onto the break, we did discuss on abuse of words. Now, sometime all words are not also sufficient. Sometimes you might be saying something very sweetly, but the action of that word might hurt, or it could be very abusive. Now, how do we keep in check and balance of words and action?
Yep. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So, abusing, verbal abuse, of course, first of all, we spoke about verbal abuse, which is prohibited, and we saw what Quran says, what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. Now, if Allah the Almighty gave you, me, and every one of us the ability or the strength in our body, the physical strength, then we must not abuse that strength.
Now,
and it must be used in the right cause and in the right things.
Now, fair enough, you've mentioned about the strength, but I'm going to talk about the shamajik babi ekto abosthan ache, jar financially ekto abosthan ache.
Yes, yes.
So not necessarily she physically dakhatse, but directly influential position of power thakar karone, he is misusing perhaps his either political, financial or social position. The itake amra kibhabe sort out korte pari.
If you just give me a few minutes, we're coming to that point.
Okay.
But we're just going to quickly discuss about the physical abuse, but we'll come to the abuse of power, inshallah. So, abuse of the strength, body, again, prohibited. And physical abuse, again, takes place a lot on this earth. Just because you are strong, just because you are more muscular, you may have apnake Allah pak rabbul alamin ektu beshi shokti diyechen, hoyto apne purush byakti, hoyto apne je kono apne hote paren, just because you have strength, apnar shorirer moddhe shokti ache, এর মানে নয় যে আপনি এই শক্তিকে অপব্যবহার করবেন, ইউ উইল অ্যাবিউজ দ্যাট স্ট্রেংথ,
মানে রং জায়গায় প্রয়োগ করতে
পারবেন না, ইয়েস. এন্ড দের আর লট অফ ফিজিক্যাল অ্যাবিউজ টেক প্লেস অন দিস আর্থ. এন্ড আওয়ার প্রফেট মুহাম্মদ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লাম হি ভেরি ক্লিয়ারলি হি সেড in a hadith mentioned in the book of Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah, where Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, إِذَا الْتَقَى الْمُسْلِمَانِ بِسَيْفِهِمَا فَالْقَاتِلُ وَالْمَقْتُولُ فِي النَّارِ, meaning if two Muslims come together with their weapons, দুজন মুসলমান তাদের নিজস্ব অস্ত্র নিয়ে তারা এক জায়গায় আসে, ইদাল তাকাল মুসলিমানি বিসাইফিহিমা, দেন প্রফেসর বলছেন ফাল কাতিলু ওয়াল মাকতুলু ফিন্নার, অর্থাৎ যে ব্যক্তি মার্ডার করেছে এবং যে ব্যক্তি মারা গেছে, দুজনই কিন্তু জাহান্নামের মধ্যে ঢুকবেন.
না, এটার কনটেক্সট আপনি কেমনে দেবেন? যখন আমরা মুসলমান দেশে তাকাই বা যে কোনো একটি মুসলিম রাষ্ট্রের দিকে আমরা তাকাই, তখন আমরা দেখি এই যে আপনি কথা বলেছেন এগুলো উদাহরণ, কিন্তু পেপার পত্রিকায় কিন্তু আমরা অহরহ দেখছি না, একটি পলিটিক্যাল আইডিয়া থাকতে পারে বা একটি ভিউ থাকতে পারে, অপোজিং ভিউ থাকতে পারে, যার জন্য আমরা এটা ইসলাম না, নাথিং টু ডু উইথ ইসলাম, জাস্ট অন ইয়োর পার্সোনাল লেভেল টু এস্টাবলিশ মাই ওন আইডিয়া ও মাই আইডিওলজিক্যাল ভ্যালিউজ ও বিলিফস. তো এই যে এগুলো আমরা যখন করি, অ্যান্ড যার জন্য মানুষ যখন মারা যায়, that's very serious then.
Exactly. So this is the reason we can have difference, we can have sort of dispute, ideological difference and dispute, but it must not go to the stage where people are actually coming together to fight one another physically
or take one another's lives.
Exactly. And this is the reason why Prophet Hassan rightly said, إِذَا الْتَقَى الْمُسْلِمَانِ بِسَيْفِهِمَا فَالْقَاتِلُ وَالْمَقْتُولُ فِي النَّارِ, if two Muslims come together to fight one another with their weapons, then both are in the fire. And then Sahaba radiallahu anhum, they asked, they were curious, they said, you know, O Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, هذا القاتل فما بال المقتول, this man, he is the murderer, it's okay for him to be in fire in Jahannam, but how about the person who's been killed, like, you know, what about him? Then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he gave a very nice beautiful answer, he said, إنه كان حريصا على قتل أخيه, because he was intending to kill his fellow Muslim brother, the other person, because he was keen on,
so there's
on killing.
An intention.
Intention counts when it comes to the bad things as well. And so Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam very clearly also said, al-muslimu man salima al-muslimuna min lisanihi wa yadihi. Imagine this hadith, I think they should be written like on in public places, where it said, Prophet ﷺ said that he is a Muslim, the one from whose hands and tongues other people are safe.
Now, unfortunately, the reality is completely different.
অর্থাৎ মানে ওই ব্যক্তি প্রকৃত প্রকারের মুসলমান যে ব্যক্তির হাত এবং তার জিহ্বা থেকে অন্য মানুষ কিন্তু সেফ নিরাপদ. They're safe and secured from the harm of the tongues and the hands. And this is the real Muslim. This is the description of a real Muslim.
Now, এখন আমরা যে দেখছি যে সমাজে বসবাস করছি, let's say, talk it a little bit openly within our community that we have. Alhamdulillah, we've got a lot of khair within our community. But the other side of the community, whenever there is an organization, if it splits into two, we see it comes down
people
to the
come
root
to,
of
yeah,
physical
yeah.
abuse.
So much intolerance within ourselves. And I think we really need to grow.
And it's not only within our community, within the Muslim community.
Yes, especially our hearts, our ridoy, our gyan, our mind can actually grow. I mean, some minor issues, we feel like we can't live with each other. We can't, right. There's no coexistence. Or that amaderke ekshathe amra boshobash korte parbo na just because I just disagree with you. We still can have a lot of disagreements. But why come to this situation? Ami mone kori eta kintu amader manusher je amader kintu ara shobbho hote hobe. We have to be much more civilized.
Now, ekhane disagreement hole ekta byapar. Eta that's one of the reason. But ekhane somoshya hocche I am correct and everyone else is wrong.
Yes.
And age manushik.
This is of course this is self self perfection mentality. We are the only people. We speak about this. We mention and we spoke. But সমস্যা হচ্ছে হ্যাঁ আপনি মনে করতে পারেন you are the person of haq. No problem. আপনি মনে করতে পারবেন সত্যতা সত্য আপনার কাছে. কিন্তু তার মানে যে আমরা ওইটা দিয়ে আমরা কিন্তু আবার physical
implementation
চলে যাব. We go and start fighting with one another. It must not go to that stage. Never. It's not possible for a Muslim to do that. So, Professor Amsa, al-Muslimu man salim al-Muslimuna min lisani, with a very important hadith that a true Muslim is the one from whose hands and tongue others are safe, other people are safe. We can give a lot of examples, but there's not much time. Now, let's just talk a little bit about the position and authority and power. Now power before, and position also a gift of Allah.
Now, before we move on to the position of power, I also want to touch another important aspect, domestic violence.
Yep.
Because that needs to be understood correctly. Sometimes many people have got to understand that domestic violence only happens on women, but also we know from the fact that it also happens in men. So if you can kindly touch on both sides.
Yeah. So nowadays, I mean, there was an understanding that you know most of the abuse actually committed by the men of hook or the generally men.
On women.
Yeah, on women. Mm. But actually nowadays it's changed a little bit. And
আগেও ছিল
কিন্তু অনেকে জানতো না কিন্তু এটা কিন্তু এটা প্রবণতা বেড়ে যাচ্ছে কিন্তু বৃদ্ধি হচ্ছে
স্টাডি বা রিসার্চে আমরা দেখছি কিন্তু ইটস নট ওনলি
yes there's abuse on men too and whoever is abusive whether men or women it is against the teaching of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam verbal as well as the physical now we have to be very careful people get angry but don't forget anger is from shaitan we need to learn how to control our anger if not then we'll lose everything we'll lose many, many things in this world. There's no chance for us to be successful.
And not only in this world, obviously it's against the law as well. So imagine the practical implication. যখন আপনি আইনের বিরুদ্ধে আপনি একটা কাজ করছেন দেশে তো এর ইম্প্যাক্ট কি হচ্ছে আপনার পরিবারে যদি যখন আইনের শাসন ব্যবস্থা যখন when it comes into effect then the implementation on the family the effect and after effect on the family
we need to really learn how to control ourselves especially when it comes to anger and I believe that there's so much rage in this world mane manusher rager je sima ta kintu onek bere geche
now
you can see people are especially amongst the young generation there's lack of patience
that's
and lack of tolerance
so ekhane jokhon if husband and wife we're just restricting it to husband and wife jodi tader kono dhoroner disagreement hotche ba bonche na should they not talk to people of understanding
exactly.
and
yes,
see if
yes,
they can
and,
mitigate
and Quran says that and also mediators counselors and also things that and a lot of time when family gets involved things become worse I think it should
so
be dealt
be?
By the independent bodies independent okay. people someone who is an under person of understanding and who's not going to side
he's
not going to be involved emotionally
tar mani hocche mani emon ekjon byakti ba shongothon hote hobe je biasness ta hobe na ebong dunush pokkhe ko china na nirpokkho
nirpokkho bhabe she eta ke deal korte pare inshallah now if Allah subhanahu wa taala give you and me and every people here in this world power because power is temporary authority position for example you may be today a boss an employer you may be a manager you may be a teacher You may be even an imam. You may be some sort of... Allah might
give
you...
Media personality.
Yes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala might give you some sort of power over other people, over creation, over the creation of Allah, the Almighty. Now, what do we do if Allah gives the power? Should we abuse this power? Should we oppress people? Should we use our power excessively on public, on other people? We have to be, again, we have to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah can boycott Tawbah. We need to really remind ourselves about what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said with regards to the power, abuse of power. He said in a hadith narrated by Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu anha, that Aisha radiallahu anha, she said, narrated, that in this house, in my house, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that, O Allah, that if anybody has been given the power over the believers, over the people, right? And if he makes things hard for him, فَشَقَّ عَلَيْهِمْ فَشْقُقْ عَلَيْهِمْ, or that Allah Pak Rabbul Alamin kuna bhaktika jodhi power diya taken, ebon oi power er maddome she manusher jibon ke kostodayak kore fale, makes it hard for people, then, O Allah, make things hard for him. Prophet is making dua against him. So if he makes things hard for people, the person of power, position, employer, boss, or maybe manager, or maybe CEO, or managing director, whoever you may be in your position, if Allah gave you the position, you must not abuse that power and use excessively on people, because Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam made dua against that person who abused the power.
Now, you can add the তত্ত্ব হচ্ছে ফর एग्जांपल যে হয়তো কোন একজন তার কোম্পানির ওয়ান অফ দি টপ লেভেল ডিরেক্টর বা ম্যানেজিং ডিরেক্টর বা রাষ্ট্রের একজন প্রধান হতে পারেন কিন্তু হয়তো দে মাইট নট নো হোয়াটস হ্যাপেনিং আন্ডারনিথ their supervision. They might perhaps are not aware of the full picture what's taking place within the system. So then
he has to try his best to make sure there's not oppression or unfairness going in his own system. Of course, you are responsible for your folk, and you have to make sure, you have to make sure that you will be questioned about your responsibility, or that we do our best. Meaning, like, I may be a CEO, I may be an MD, I may be a prime minister, I may be an MP, I may be a mayor, I may be in any position, right? I need to try my level best to make sure in my system there is no oppression happening. Otherwise, if I'm not trying, then Allah will question me. Okay. After my efforts,
abilities,
then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها.
So that means
Allah doesn't overburden people.
তার মানে হচ্ছে যে তার নিজের দায়িত্ব থাকতে হবে. It needs to be seen that he or she is doing something.
Exactly, yes, okay. Yes. Trying. Now, so we see people are in position and unfortunately they abuse their power. And Prophet made dua against them. And he said also towards the end of the hadith, he said, O Allah, if someone's been given the power and he make things easy for people, O Allah, make things easy for him, for that person. যদি উনি মানুষের জন্য সহজ করে জীবনকে সহজ করতে পারে তাহলে তার জীবনটাও এবং তার যত জিনিসগুলো আছে সহজ করে দাও সো আল্লাহ সুবহানাহু ওয়া তাআলা মেড আল্লাহ প্রফেট মুহাম্মদ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়া সাল্লাম মেড দুআ ফর দ্য পারসন হু ডাজ হু অ্যাবিউজেস দ্য পাওয়ার এন্ড হু ডাজন্ট অ্যাবিউজ দ্য পাওয়ার এন্ড দেন উই ফাইন্ড that people sometime we hear a complaint that people don't give the wages on time. You see, we heard many stories that some people, like employed people, worked for months and years, not maybe years, but for a long time. But towards the end, the employer doesn't give the money, the wages,
or do not give it on time.
On time. Mm-hmm. And then Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, "Look at this beautiful teaching of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. A'tul ajira ajrahu qabla an yajiffa 'araquhu." He said, "Give the ajr, the wages, to the person who worked before his sweat dried out." অর্থ তার গাম শুকার আগে তার গাম তার যে কাজের যে গামটা আছে এই গামটা শুকানোর আগেই তার আজটা দিয়ে দাও আতুল আজির আজরহু ক্বাবলা আন ইয়াজিফা আরাক
তার মানে এখানে
কত গিভ অন টাইম মিনিং
তার মানে হচ্ছে এখানে কত বড় একটি দায়িত্ব আছে যারা ভালো ইনফ্লুয়েন্সিয়াল পজিশন আছেন বা কোম্পানির মালিক আছেন তাদের যে কর্মচারী আছেন
ইয়েস
ওয়েদার
ইট এন্ড দ্যাটস অলসো মোটিভেট পিপল ইওর ওয়ার্কারস দ্য পিপল হু আর ওয়ার্কিং ফর ইউ ইট মোটিভেটস ওয়েন ইউ গিভ ওয়েজেস অন টাইম আই মিন দেয়ার ইজ সাম টাইম incapability.
Exception like, yeah,
hote pare je ami parchi na ba shombhob hocche na kintu regular bhabe mane sob shomoy regular bhabe eta kora kintu rasul karim sahab er teaching er against
tar mane amra jara business er malik achi, whether it be takeaway, whether it be grocery shop, whether it be big construction businesses, amra time mote due time e je beton amader ke nirdharon kore diyechi amra amader kormochari
amader wada ke amra rakha korte hobe
time motei dite hobe
obosshoi time moto jodi eta promise hoye thake tale promise ke rakha korte hobe jodi kintu er moddhe kono ye thake je ami ektu pore dibo ba erokom kono khota thake jay tahole eta different al muslimuna inda shurutihim muslims are according to their mutual agreements as professor Alan said or তাদের মধ্যে যদি কোনো অভ্যন্তরীণ কোনো এগ্রিমেন্ট থেকে যায় তাহলে এটা ভিন্ন কথা বাট জেনারেলি ইফ দ্যাট ইজ দ্য কেস ইফ দ্যাট ইজ প্রমিস দেন ইট মাস্ট বি ফুলফিল নাও অপারেশন ক্যান টেক প্লেস এগেইন ইফ ইউ আর এ পার্সন অফ অথরিটি নাও ডোন্ট ফরগেট দ্যাট ইউ আর ইন পাওয়ার ফর অল হোল এন্টায়ার লাইক লাইফ বিকজ পাওয়ার অথরিটি পজিশনস আর টেম্পোরারি وتلك الايام نداولها بين الناس you may be a person of power but you may not you know after a few years or after a few months you may not be in that position
now you can act in shame touch korte chaichi jara amader masjid committee te involve achen tara imam der proti tader je rokom behavior amra jekhon onek ghotona shunechi amader kache onek email esheche paper potrike onek kichu dekhechi apni imam definitely apni onek ghotona shunechen na jara committee er daitte achen president bolen ba secretary bolen imam jara achen এই যে ইমামদের সাথে যেভাবে ব্যবহার করা হয় স্পেশালি উই আর টকিং অ্যাবাউট ব্রিটিশ বর্ন ইমামস উই আর টকিং অ্যাবাউট ইমামস ফ্রম অ্যাব্রড
যারা when they come to question
just when they are subject to immigration control when they are subject to some sort of weakness the way we treat the imams what would you say
said unfortunate of course there are some mistakes coming from the sides of imam too I must agree but at the same time there's lots of misbehavior from the managements especially the mosque managements we must be very careful look Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wala tahsabanna Allah ghafilan amma ya'malu adh-dhalimun don't think Allah is not aware of what the zalim is doing what the oppressor is doing don't think he's not aware but innama yu'akhiruhum but he delays it অর্থাৎ উনি একটু বিলম্ব করে থাকেন আল্লাহ পাক রব্বুল আলামিন কিন্তু এটা কিন্তু বলে উনি জানেন না এটা বিষয় না
তার মানে তারাও হচ্ছে যারা কমিটির দায়িত্বে আছেন এবং তারা যদি জুলুম করে থাকেন ইমামদের
প্রতি তাহলে আল্লাহ পাক রব্বুল দেখছেন ইয়েস ইয়েস ওয়ালা তাহসাবান্না আল্লাহ গাফিলান আম্মা ইয়ামালু যালিমুন ইনমা ইউআখিরুহুম লিয়াউমিন তাশখাসু ফিহি আলআবসার জাস্ট ইজ ডিলেইং দ্য টাইম টু দ্য রাইট টাইম টু টেক এন্ড টু গিভ দ্য প্রপার লেসন এন্ড টিচিং And we have seen the people who have oppressed in recent years. You have seen like people of authority for 45 years, no kalam, nobody
can. Correct.
But then what happened? So we see these things in front of our eyes. So we have to be careful when it comes to this thing. Now, again, there's another thing. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you wealth, money, which we mentioned earlier, or if he put you in a position to deal with the public fund, the people's money, baytul mal, right? We have to be very, very careful again because we are accountable in front of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. You may think, oh, this fulan is not so-and-so person, he's not aware, or maybe the people in the committee are not aware. You might be a position, you're in a charity organization, you might be dealing with any sort of money-related issues, right? Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, He is the most important CCTV.
Now, এখানে আরেকটা কথা আছে মনে করেন আমাদের অনেক সংগঠন আছে যারা হয়তো এখান থেকে পাবলিক ফান্ড পেয়ে থাকেন সরকারের কাছ থেকে ডিফারেন্ট ডিফারেন্ট সোর্ট অফ ফান্ড পেয়ে থাকেন না অনেক সময় দেখি আমাদের অ্যাকাউন্টেবিলিটির অভাব আছে অ্যান্ড দেন সামটাইম উই ইউজ লেম এক্সকিউজেস লাইক দিস আর এরা তো মুসলমান না এদের ভাষা মিস ইউজ করলে কোনো অসুবিধা নাই না
No. We are responsible. Anything that's just under our position, our authority, we are responsible for them. And remember, everything will be questioned. We will be questioned about by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Transparency must be there. You know, you may think people are not knowing. I don't mean to say everybody's people are doing intentionally, but sometimes mistakes are taking place unintentionally. But we are Muslims, we are believers, and Allah the Almighty will question us. And Quran says very clearly, وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ رَقِيبًا Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is raqib. He is monitoring at all time. He is looking and viewing very closely what we do. يَعْلَمُ خَائِنَةَ الْأَعْيُنُ مَا تُخْفِي الصُّدُورِ What is betrayal by eyes as well as what's hidden in the hearts and in the chest. Allah knows everything. And the last thing that we want to say, mention today about the abuse, and that's something very common and we see here a lot in the media, আমরা দেখতে পাচ্ছি, that is sexual abuse. And it's taking place, and it did take place, and it's even taking place. Now, what happens here? Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala gave some people some sort of, again, power. Maybe like somebody manager, maybe somebody coach, football coach, or maybe any kind of trainer. Someone maybe like a teacher, people trust them, give them some sort of trust. And maybe like relatives, like cousin, brothers, sisters, or maybe someone like a far distance, মানে একজন relative, আত্মীয় হতে পারে, আত্মীয় হতে পারে. কিন্তু ওনারা কি করেন? এই এই যে পাওয়ারটা, এই যে এই যে অ্যাবিলিটিটা ওনারা অ্যাবিউজ করে থাকেন. The people use this in order to take advantage by committing crime such as sexual abuse. And if zina is something that is taken as something really serious in Quran, which happens by the agreement of two people, how about the abuse that take place without any kind of agreement,
that the consent
of consent of the other person? Now, the victims of the sexual abuse are mostly children, the daughters, the girls, women, and even some men, and even some cases some men. We must be very careful. Don't forget, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he gives the consequences, a punishment Allah pak rabbul alamin diye taken. Ebong amra onek story shuni je onek teacher ase, onek
misuse their position,
ebong trust ke misuse kore, onek kintu tara jounobhabe manusher ke hoirani kore, joun hoirani jeta ke bola hoy sexually. And we see in the media, we've seen the people who have done committed these crimes a long time ago, it's coming up now.
মানে মুদ্দা কথা হচ্ছে যে আপনি হয়তো আজকে লুকে এগুলা কিছু
হাইড করেছেন, আপনি জনবে হরানি করছেন ছেলে মেয়েদেরকে, মহিলাদেরকে.
বাট
অ্যানাদার থিং, দ্য এফেক্ট অফ দিস ইজ ভেরি সিভিয়ার. Very severe, and those who perpetrate these crimes, they have to be very careful. Allah will punish them very seriously, because this effect of abuse, it stays with people, not only just for years, sometimes throughout the whole entire life.
So that means people need to take into the help and support of the legal enforcement
and
that are
and the responsible of the children. We need to be careful as well. Who do we trust? And I don't mean to say don't trust anybody, but you have to be careful. Awakefulness. আমাদের সতর্ক এবং সজাগ থাকতে হবে.
মানে আমাদেরকে blindly কোনো জিনিস যেন believe না করি.
এবং আমাদেরকে carefully আমাদেরকে deal করতে হবে.
অসংখ্য ধন্যবাদ. আর আমরা continue করতে পারছি না, সময় একদমই শেষ. ইনশাআল্লাহ, thank you ever so much once again for this beautiful discussion and very timely, effective discussion. Inshallah, I will see you in our next episode.
Inshallah, ya Rabbil Alamin.
With this, we have come to the conclusion of our tonight's discussion. There are three elements that we'll be highlighting as a summary. The first thing the Sheikh has mentioned about the domestic violence, we have to all be very careful, whether it be men and women, inshallah, we should all be responsible towards our action. And if there is any disputes or disagreement, please get in touch with the organization or a body or an individual that are independent, who may have no influence on either of the side. The second thing Sheikh have touched about is the influence of power, the misuse of power. Those who are in the position of power, whether it be within the political arena, whether it be in an organization, in a society, in a committee, financially, economically, or socially, we have to all ensure that one day we will all be accountable for the action that we're doing. And always remember, the people who are less fortunate than us, they should always be treated with dignity, with respect, and deserve the same right as us. And lastly, the Sheikh has touched upon those individuals who are involved in committee of masajids, the way we treat our imam, we have to be very, very careful. Amadra imam dirke jara juggo alim ulama, we have to learn how to respect them. We have to learn how to listen, and if they are qualified, to understand the Quran and Sunnah in the correct context. Jara masjid committee shathe jorito achen, ebong if you are misusing your power against the imam, one day you'll be responsible in the day of judgment, inshallah. Yeah. With all of this, inshallah, we take your leave. Until next time, subhanakallahumma wa hamdik, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Jazakallah khair, Sheikh.